esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This time, we're a little bit closer to being ready here with the SLTV Starseries Season 10 Finals. Of course, this is now a LAN Finals, as it's been for a very long time, so it's going to be pretty exciting seeing these teams play. It's Fnatic and myXMG first in a best. And you're right, Room on Fire, and with me, of course, as always, is Semran Vendetta. How are you guys doing?
Doing pretty good. Kind of tired, this being fairly early for me, being on that, you know, hardcore gamer sleeping schedule, I guess.
Is that the schedule where you go to sleep at this time?
Yeah, about that, about this time.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I actually had to really force myself to, I actually got really up really early yesterday so that I could go to bed early yesterday and then try and see if I could fix it, but it's not that easy, is it?
I had just managed to reset my sleeping schedule from Gamescom, which I had, I guess what normal people would regard as healthy, and went back to my regular schedule. It didn't quite work out.
Yeah, well, sometimes, right, it's too much fun being up in the middle of the night, that's the thing. I've tried to figure out for years why it is, and I think, for me at least, there's something very relaxing about knowing that when it's like 3 in the morning, nobody's going to call you about anything. You're not going to get any weird emails from anyone wanting anything from you. You can just be yourself and no one will have to you know, interrupt you. There's something nice about that.
Yeah, man. Definitely. Something nice about it. I mean, when you used to drive around LA, or like a big city, right? You know, and it's like 3 in the morning and you feel like you got the whole place to yourself. You know, like that you see like one car on the road, you know, and you're like, okay, what's up, man? But, you know, you keep on driving, you got the good tunes going and everything is nice. Everything's comfortable. That's what it's about, being a night owl.
Yeah, I know what you mean. That's it. So maybe that's part of the reason. But anyway, we have got up pretty early, at least by gamer standards. And we've got myXMG and Fnatic playing it out against each other. This is the first match. And because we have a double elimination bracket here, it means that even if you lose this, you're not going to be out. But it will obviously get a lot more difficult fighting your way through the lower bracket. It's today and tomorrow that all these matches are going on, and we'll be covering every single one of them right here on the channel. So big welcome, big thanks to all of you for tuning in, especially if you're, you know, from a different time zone where it's even earlier in the morning. So, yeah, thanks for doing that, guys, and we hope you're going to enjoy the show here. Now, this is a best-of-three game, but does anyone think that myXMG has a chance in hell of beating Fnatic in a best-of-three on LAN?
The fact that you prefaced that it's on LAN, that makes me sad, because I was about to pull out the fact that they did play just a couple of days ago, actually, in a best of three, and myXMG took a map off of Fnatic and the Hitbox Arena Challenge.
Yeah.
So, obviously, they have the opportunity or the potential to take a map off of Fnatic, but seeing how it is on LAN, Fnatic are by far the most experienced team, all that kind of stuff, I think this should be a 2-0 victory for Fnatic.
Oh, I mean, we have the little trophy right there by their names. You know, if you look at Krims, finalist at ESL 1 Cologne 2014, that kind of says it all. You're talking about the team, a Swedish team at that, that got into the finals of the latest major and barely lost it to NIP in the end. So this is a team to be feared. This is a favorite to take the whole thing here at Starseries this weekend. So we have to keep a close eye on Fnatic.
Yeah, I agree. It is. I think that's what it is. But it's not like myXMG don't have good players. I just think they have a lot less experience playing together. And
and
they also sort of came here on a bit of a, you know, because Mousesports actually ended up leaving the ship early, right? They just said, you know, we're not gonna go to Kiev this time around. I think there were like a number of issues that chimed in for them that meant they couldn't really go. So ultimately, myXMG stepped up.
Is it not the same reason that Fnatic used last Star Series? Essentially, civil unrest in the country kind of scaring Mouse off. But, you know, Fnatic had that excuse last time, and they're here this time, wondering about Mouse.
Yeah, and there are some regional, you know, controversies going on, I suppose we could say. But in order to avoid turning it into a big political debate, I think we should just say that yes, Mousesports decided it wasn't really worth going. And myXMG luckily did step it up, but that's good because you know it's really weird having a four team final with only three teams. That would be confusing.
Slightly awkward.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How would you solve that? That's when you pull people out of the crowd. You're like, you want to play on stage? Yeah, go ahead. There you go, bud. It's time to make a name for yourself. It's your chance. Go.
It's now or never. Do or die.
Yeah. Apart from that, it's my understanding that a lot of the unrest is pretty damn far from Kiev, which is obviously where this is being played in the cyber arena. So I think people are pretty safe anyway. The map pool, though, I believe it is Dust 2, then Mirage, and then Inferno as the final and deciding map if it goes down to
it. And we should make it perfectly clear that there's still a train in this map pool as well.
That's a really good point. That's actually really worth bringing
up. Yeah, and it's only a 5-map map pool.
Yep. Yep.
So, I mean, what it means is, at least to my mind, even if myXMG, and Dust 2 is a kind of map where I think myXMG, if they have any chance of winning a map, it's going to be on Dust 2, basically. Not necessarily because Fnatic is banned at it, just because we all sort of know by this point how Dust 2 functions as a map, how much it matters, having a good start, and also just generally, you know, being off to a good roll in the beginning. But even if they take Dust 2, Mirage is a map that Fnatic are definitely decent at playing, and Inferno is a map that they're terrifyingly good at playing. So I still think the odds are really, really heavily stacked against Fnatic. Against their myXMG. And for Fnatic to lose this, I imagine it's going to require something more than just a few slip-ups. We're talking like a team breakdown, essentially, I think. And that can happen. I mean, I'm not ruling it out. I'm just saying I think it's that scale we're looking at for Fnatic to lose this.
Yeah, to paint a picture here for those of you who are unaware. In that recent game that Fnatic had versus myXMG, they did play Mirage and Inferno, and both of those maps went pretty heavily in the favor of Fnatic. I think Mirage ended up 16-3, Inferno 16-7. The one map that myXMG actually took off of Fnatic was Overpass, and if we recall back to Gamescom, Fnatic looked like a really solid team on Overpass.
Yeah, you're very right, indeed. They did.
Yeah, but I completely agree with what you said. I think if they want to get off to... I think if they want to win this, they have to get Dust 2. But then again, we've seen them beat some pretty good teams on Dust 2. That amazingly strange game we saw with myXMG versus Na'Vi was on Dust 2, where myXMG actually beat Na'Vi 16-14.
Yeah, and they played really well. And it's not like they don't have talent. I mean, Vendetta, you know this better than I. But I think Hunden in Source was actually a pretty decent Danish player, wasn't he?
Oh yeah, well, all of these guys have been pretty good players in Source. Kevin is probably the one with the best achievement list from Source. He's been in all kinds of top European teams for several years. He's kind of similar to Nico. He's the kind of guy who doesn't play all that much, shows up at LANs, just dominates people, and then goes somewhat inactive. But if he plays a lot, then he's a monster. Hunden's been in several top teams in Denmark over the years. Same thing with MSL. Obviously, you know MSL from previous CSGO teams as well.
Yeah.
His teams with Pimp and Nilla and all those guys. And PNX, who I guess we could call a newcomer. At least in CS terms, he's a bit of a newcomer, at least to the CSGO fans. He actually used to play with Izzy back in Oxmos, which was pretty much a gathering of a lot of Danish talents. I think MupsG, who now plays for the team that used to be... Yeah, no, sir. The team that actually won Assembly as myXMG. And Izzy, who now plays in Dignitas. So a lot of good players all across the board, really, for myXMG. But as you said or alluded to earlier on, they don't really have the advantage experience-wise when it comes to playing as a team at big LAN events.
Yeah, I think that's what it comes down to in the end. I mean, so really, if myXMG stuck together for 3 or 4 months and put in a really hard work and practice, they could probably be a really cool team. But right now, they're playing against a Fnatic that's You know, with the infusion of Crimson, Olofmeister seems to be just one of the best teams in the world, basically. So that's what it comes down to in the very end. But welcome to the show, guys. This is Room on Fire and the SLTV Star Series Season 10 Finals. First game of the finals. Next game coming up after this best of three is going to be Hellraisers and Na'Vi, and that will be one hell of a clash as well. But for now, just welcome to the show, and let's see how Dust 2 is going to play out.
Apparently, there's a bit of a problem here with the config. You can only get one flash.
Yeah, so, old school CSGO config.
Old school, then old school. We'll have to see about fixing that fairly quickly here, so we can get this game underway. Because both teams are ready, and I'm really excited to see now what myXMG actually have to show us here, because they are starting on the T side of Dust 2. So that is that's already a strong. At least it gives them the opportunity for a strong start here. If they can get a few rounds in early on. Start the ball rolling, you know, maybe get rid of the jitters at the start. Once you first sit down, right, you're about to play Fnatic, you got to put all that out of your mind and just focus on your game. If they could pick up that pistol round, this would be a big opportunity for XMG to get a strong start in this best of three.
Yeah, I agree. And actually, I think, and this is something I think I've brought up almost too many times at this point, I think generally Danish teams fare a little bit better if they are the underdog. And I think I don't think myXMG have ever been more in an underdog position than they are right now, basically. There's that thing going on for them. I think they do better in general if nobody expects anything from them. And I mean, I think myXMG more than anything else are here to get the experience too, and also here to maybe show some people that they are you have to take them seriously. So
this is something we have to highlight. I mean, it's a great opportunity for them, seeing as how Mousesports have bowed out, for them to get some land experience, for them to get some exposure, and to show what they're capable of versus one of the very best. You know, all three of these teams, the other three teams are in this tournament, apart from myXMG, Fnatic, obviously, but then you also have Hellraisers and Na'Vi. So these are going to be some great teams for myXMG to play against. And if they can make an upset, just imagine the kind of... like they're the reputation in the scene right there, Rockets. If you can manage to take a best of three versus any of these teams on land,
yeah, that would not be bad at all. I mean, even I would even be surprised. Even on Dust 2, I'd be surprised if IXMG can pick up the first map here. I think that would be a huge achievement. But even if they don't, I still, you know, still just playing the maps. And again, if they lose, they're not out. They're just going to go to lower brackets. So they will get a lot of chances to play against some of the best teams in the world. And that's worth a lot. And for the pistol round, which is already live now, they're going to rush straight into the bomb site. Actually, really good flashes to start off with here. Crims, though, will pick up the first headshot. Flusher has to land a shot. He's going to go down to Tenski. So this is a good start. And they drop Pronax outside as well.
Oh, that was a sick jumping shot by MSL. Just caught Pronax at the door. It's going to be two remaining members here for Fnatic, but into a 2-on-2 we go, as Olofmeister does manage to find MSL. JW waiting at window, doesn't get a kill though, and now Fnatic actually have to try and find a big shot here to get their way in.
And Tenski's actually going to pick up his second kill of the round. Olofmeister's now 1-on-2. He's got the time here. He's going to pick up one more. That's now a triple, but he hasn't got a kit. He just picks one up on the plateau. Now it's a 1-on-1. Hoonan is right there. Olofmeister's going to go for it, but it will be myXMG that pick up the pistol round, and that's exactly the kind of start they needed. It was close at the end. Olofmeister almost dropping four kills, but not good enough.
Not good enough. Fnatic more or less needed to get more done with the initial defense from Flusher and Krems there to hold that off, because myXMG focused so heavily on actually getting B control. It was only PNX who was just lurking around at long, who really wasn't committed to that B push.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, the thing is that Flusher kind of got caught behind Big Red there, and he wasn't able to get out behind it and get another shot. Krims with the first headshot, that was really solid, but after that, kind of didn't go Fnatic's way. And then you're talking about a B retake. Luckily, Olofmeister finds the kill to turn it into a 2-on-2 very quickly, but if it's a 3-on-2, it's not looking too hot there for Fnatic. One thing here is that Olofmeister has managed to sneak his way into lower dark, so there may be a bit of an opportunity because quite a few of my XMG members are up in upper looking at B again.
Look how low they all are. Crims has actually hit a number of shots with the scout that he's picked up, and that's really going to cause some trouble now. Flusher, grenade rains in. Is it going to land? Oh, it does take down Hunden and almost kills the second person as well. PNX is going to pick up Flusher in return, but they're very soft right now, the Danes, and they're actually going to be dropping like flies here.
Yeah, Olofmeister's position is just crucial. Now Pronax manages to find MSL, and he's going to get the second kill as well. PNX is out. But that was all Olofmeister getting in that flank so quickly because he was in lower dark. As soon as they tried to jump on B, he's just instantly flanking them and gets two kills with a CZ. So that's a really nice play there by Fnatic and just the Crims Olofmeister combo. We saw this combo just time and time again all throughout Gamescom wreak havoc. These guys are the ones we have to be watching on this team right now. The recent addition from, I guess, XLGB, they've been doing great work for the Fnatic lineup.
Yeah, they really have, and they're not going to stop here, it seems. I mean, I'm still fairly convinced that we've not seen neither Olafmeister or Krims actually peak at their skill in Global Offensive, but and they're already doing well. Great spray down from Flusher. That control with the AK at that distance is sort of get right level spray control, which is very impressive, and that's going to finish that eco round really quickly. My XMG with no pistols, just with no rifles, just running in, they instantly got shot down.
Yeah, pretty textbook anti-eco from Fnatic's side. Not really much myXMG could do, and it's not like it's a big worry for them either, because they didn't invest a whole lot into it, and they're not either gonna invest all that much into this round either. A ZZ and a couple of nades picked up, and that's it.
Yeah, it seems like they really want to maximize their money at this point. They have another round of eco going in. I'm sure Kev wants to see if he can pick up an AWP at some point soon. Seeing as how he was ecoing in that first buy round for myXMG as well, just going with the pistol. So, again, it's going to be a B-split push. Olafmeister is right behind them, though, very quickly, but they're still flush alive on the site, and he mows them down as they come through the window. This is just completely shut down for myXMG.
So, you know, quad to follow up on the triple E at last round. That puts Flusher at 8-0-2. I mean, they're eco-franks, but still a lot of money, and you know, generally, I think he's going to be feeling pretty great about himself. And
yeah,
you did point out the AWP
there with
here.
The rifle.
Yeah, that's not bad, right?
I got to pad the stats, man. That's the thing. We see how important it is, right? You know, Gamescom released their latest stats for the tournament, all that jazz. You got people vying for, you know, who got the most frags, who had the best headshots. Flusha, he's like, I'm going to have the most frags in this tournament. I'm going to get all those eco frags.
MSL actually forced back with a Molotov. That's kind of a clever move. Look at JW. He can actually clear Longhouse just using a Molotov here, and that's kind of nice. That's, I think, a good investment.
That's a nice move, but he could get picked off, though. Although it doesn't happen as he takes out MSL. I'm actually surprised that MSL opted to go in there all by himself, because he seemed like he had an ID that JW had pushed aggressively in. So I would have liked to see him bring one teammate with him so he could at least get the trade frag there.
Yeah, maybe some HE grenades as well. Down the middle, though, Hunden is going to be picking up Olafmeister, who was looking the wrong way at the wrong time. They're rushing up the middle, but the problem is there are two people in upper dark from Fnatic, and they're going to hold really strong. Great headshot from Krims, follows up with another one, leaving Tenski alone in a one-on-two, and he can probably get the bomb down here, but defending it is a different matter. He's actually going to go and try and equalize, makes it a one-on-one, and JW will take him down. But I still think, what do you say, Ven? Is that a good idea, doing it a one-on-one instead of a one-on-two?
Oh yeah, absolutely. JW just barely got him down in time, and if Tenski is able to just down Pronax and drop down and get the bomb plant, then you leave yourself in a really good position to actually do some good. But yeah, that round was simply won because Crimson Flushout just opted to go aggressively into VAPs or upper dark.
Great grenade use once again over on Long here. They will actually be able to take down JW, which is probably a little bit annoying for him, but I love the fact that they use Molotovs and HE grenades in quick succession to take down the incoming eco rush. So that works out just great for them. I mean, right now, Summer, it's 5-1, and I mean, Fnatic, I feel like we haven't even overhyped them. They are playing about as well as I imagined they would.
Yeah. Well, they got control back with a very smart strat in the second round, and this is also something that we see teams do on Dust2 more and more often now, regardless of side, is once they really start to get a couple rounds together, they just start looking like this behemoth that's never going to slow down. Kevs is interested in making them slow down, though, whether they like it or not. Olafmeister is down, but JW and Pronax push to the top of mid and pick up a kill to even it up.
Oh, and JW even got that kill on Tenski, which I'm not sure he should have had. He had a grenade out by the time Tenski spotted him, but he couldn't finish it off in time. And this is kind of a power play coming out from Fnatic. Just when they definitely knew that myXMG were going to be buying this round, and then they thought, all right, you're going to be buying. We're gonna basically take the fight right to your doorstep before you even realize. And Pronax orping in the middle is going to take down Kevin after a really good flashbang. I mean, Vendetta, this seems almost like something you'd see VODS Pro doing, right?
Yeah, it's actually very VODS Pro-esque, but Fnatic did do this exact same push with JW and Pronax up into mid at Gamescom as well, with a high success rate. So this is definitely something they've planned to do. It's a calculated risk. It's kind of similar to pushing aggressively into lobby like Nip do on Nuke.
Good flashbangs coming out on long here from myXMG. That's actually forced the Fnatic members back, and JW's caught in a really awkward spot here by the car. You don't really want to be stuck here. Pronex is doing his best to try and help him out, but they could end up both falling unless some backup comes in pretty quickly. And Fnatic, well, they're shuffling around, but they're not overcommitting to any kind of rotation right now.
No, one thing for JW is that there's only one HE here, and it's on Tensky, so they need to find him with guns, and they do that. PNX catches JW before he can get back into CT just as he rounds the corner. And now Fnatic, it's been... they lose the first kill, but there's been a lot of damage dealt to both sides. Pronex down low, but MSL sitting on 2 HP. Olafmeister, though, he has the AWP. He picks it up, and this is the danger of Fnatic. Now he can go to work.
Yeah, he will do just that. Really nicely played from Olafmeister. Picks up a double, and Flush has also got a double. And Tensky is alone in the middle. Actually, will spray down Krim, so that's a really nice kill. Still, I got 40 seconds left to try and do this one-on-two, but the bomb is all the way down on long. So not only does he have to kill someone and make it a one-on-one, then actually don't think he even has time to do this. He has to kill both of them, and maybe that's the reason why Fnatic are spreading out so far as they are.
They want, like, flushes right now in a lurk spot at the top of mid, looking towards Longhouse, right? So if he tries to come in through Longhouse, he's gone, and then you have Olafmeister who's sitting on A slope looking towards short, so they've just boxed him out. Oh, great headshot, though. Olafmeister missing the flick. That was crucial, but there's only 13 seconds left. Flusha actually just needs to run away at this point, because if he dies here, that would be a huge throw from him.
Yeah, it would be. Tensky realizes 3, 2, 1, and Flusha goes down. Tensky picks up the 1-on-2. A big mistake from Fnatic. You're absolutely right, Semler. That should have been... You called it just right, I think. That's it.
Oh, man. Well, that's Fnatic getting a little bit ahead of themselves, I think. Getting a little overconfident. I don't know, Van. What do you think about that sort of situation? Honestly, should Flusha even be in that position when there's only 10 seconds left?
No, there's no reason for him to be there. That's just a huge, huge, huge mistake from Flusha. And this could be the one thing that put, you know, gives myXMG the opportunity to get back into this.
Yeah, certainly going to try and pick up on it here. JW still alive on 8 HP, picking up another person. Does miss the next shot, and that's going to be the end of him. Down the middle, Flusher is going to go down to Hunden, and now that leaves Olafmeister and Krims here. And they got to be a little bit careful, but Olafmeister will pick up the one kill. So we're right back into a 2-on-2, and Kevin wants to see if he can flash himself into a kill here. He does get the flash off. Olafmeister still alive, and he's going to go down to Hunden, coming up from short. So now it's Krims' turn to try and see if he can make up for last round.
Hunden is low enough that if Krims was to take a shot, and he's going to go for the plant as well. Krims could be in the ideal position to deny this. Hunden knows, though, and he's going to be able to plant safe, but Krims takes out his teammate in the meantime, and Krims gets the jumping shot through the box. No time for Hunden to move and get into a safer position. Krims just shuts him down single-handedly, and Fnatic just come right back into this game. No, nothing is easy here for myXMG. They have to scratch their way through every round.
Yeah, just, I mean, there's nothing more to say, really, is there? I think you put it nicely, Vendetta. This was the perhaps that last round with Tensky doing that 1-on-2. That should have been the momentum boost right back in, and they almost got the round home. If they could have won the second round in a row here, that would have been a good platform to build something from. Now instead, well, they're right back in the gutter, aren't they?
Yeah. That nade. Oh, that's a wince nade right there, and it's just a slaughter. Yeah, just complete and utter devastation. Sick nade to start, right on the money, right on top of two guys, dropping them down to around 20 HP, doing just massive damage, and then you have the crossfire on B. It just annihilates myXMG, so 8-2 the score right now. Fnatic, again, their money is not threatened. That's the real problem here, is that XMG aren't able to put a couple rounds on the board, chain them together to force Fnatic into a bit of an uncomfortable position as far as their money is concerned. They just aren't able to do it.
And now Fnatic are doing the same aggressive push up into mid as soon as they know that myXMG has the money to buy out.
Yeah, this time they actually get punished. Look at PNX picking up some absolutely sick headshots with that AK down from Lord Dark. And that's going to leave Flusher and Krims alone. I think Kevin also picked up a kill on somebody with the AWP. So that was, I mean, yeah, this time they managed to adjust. And myXMG, they actually saw it coming quite a while away because, or quite some distance away, because they saw the people rushing through middle. And, Tensky's going to take down Krims, leaving Flusher alone. The really great thing about this round is that Kevin actually spotted the first two people running through the double doors in the middle, and then he was going to go and re-peek them to try and take a shot, but I think he realized that there was someone AWPing behind them, so if he actually had re-peeked against the people rushing through, I think he would have gone down almost immediately. So I'm glad he had the patience and the calm to not go for that re-peek in the middle. Small detail, but that set it up nicely.
Yes.
Yeah, it's one of those small details that actually is huge, because at least he stays alive and he gives the information to his teammates. He sees three guys pushing. He's like, okay, then we know exactly what's going on and his teammates can adjust. JW with a nice shot on Kev to start here, however, that's not going to help things for myXMG, who once again need to start putting two rounds together, right? They need to start putting one round after the other, chaining them together to really have an effect here on Fnatic's money. So losing a man early like this is not going to help things.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised to see them commit out into mid here, because they've forgotten the bomb and spawn.
Alright, that is certainly interesting, and, you know, it means even if they get the bomb site, they're going to have a really hard time winning the round unless Fnatic make more big mistakes here. PNX and Hunden are left, it's a 2-on-3. I mean, they have plenty of time to actually go back and pick up the bomb, but somebody right now on the Danish team has to be asking, where's that bomb, guys?
And the big issue is that they have to go through two Fnatic members to actually get to that bomb now. And I don't think the Fnatic members are aware of the fact that they don't have the bomb yet, but it's working out pretty well for them.
PNX is going to pick up the kill.
How is this going to work? Is Pronax going to work his way back through T-spawn? Or is he just going to kind of sit in upper dark and expect the flank? Because he is actually running all the way back into T-spawn right now, PNX, to go pick up that bomb. Pronax is about to run into him, though. As he rounds the corner, he could potentially spot him, but he's just a second too late. And now PMX, 20 seconds left. Does he just run straight for A site? It looks like it.
If this works, it's the sickest mind game ever. I'm gonna call it as not a mistake and just, you know, they planned it all along, right? I don't know what to say. Grenade! Oh, Crims runs right into it! Great job from PNX. Maybe a little bit random, but it worked great. That's our triple kill. He wins this one-on-one. It may be just about the most absurd strat we've seen in a very long time. Oh, but he's looking the wrong way.
Surely he must hear.
Yeah, he does hear it. PNX goes for the spray, and he cannot connect to it. Pronax will take him down, so in the end, leaving the bomb and spawn turns out to be not a success.
Well, given how that round looked to be going, I guess they should be pretty happy about just getting a plant down. and they still do okay damage to Fnatic. Flush is the only guy who's going to have any money at all, really, as soon as Fnatic are done buying. Or actually, he decides to drop to Pronax, not to all of my... No. So yeah, he drops around, so JW is the only guy who's actually got a tiny bit of cash left, and that's about it.
It's not the end of the world in this situation, I guess. It's just Fnatic have got 9 rounds now on their CT side, so they have to be feeling pretty good. Regardless, now they can start going for some more aggression. JW at Longhouse is supported by Olafmeister. MSL just stands his ground, though, trying to take the shot, and it looks like he's going to manage to make it out of there in one piece. So at least they exchange info, and nobody goes down. Both teams still kind of even here.
It's definitely a switch up on Fnatic's CT side, how aggressively they're playing this Longhouse. I mean, it's not that we've never seen it from teams before, but I'm pretty sure Fnatic in the past have not been this aggressive with JW over here. And it's kind of cool to see it happen, but Kevin, they're learning, at least myXMG are learning about what Fnatic are doing. And that's going to open up the kill with them, but immediately afterwards, MSL goes down to Olafmeister, who's now in the pit hiding.
Yeah, this is going to be an A split, though. They're almost up onto the site. Pronax is alive on A slope. He guns one down. Hunden still manages to take one out. That's Flusha, who's been picked off along, but Olafmeister is still at Longhouse, holding that point. And so the A split just completely fails. XMG have to fall back, and there's Crims cutting him off in CT spawn, so they can't even get to the B site right now. Kev is alone in a 1v3 now, stuck at mid.
Yeah, and actually, I think if they'd got that kill on Crims, who was in the CT spawn, there would have been a really good chance they could have put the bomb down and defended it really well. So that was, I think, that's really what broke the round for myXMG. And now the trouble is, because they won a round about 3 rounds ago, now they don't have any money. They haven't put the bomb down either. So they're going to have to eco in the 14th round when it's 10-3. That is not fun at all.
It really isn't. And that's been the problem for myXMG the entire game. They haven't been able to string consecutive rounds together. So they have to pay with it, and they're ecoing way more than what they need to do on their T side.
Yeah, that's the big thing here. It's just Fnatic are the ones controlling the money. Fnatic are winning those key rounds that would put them on eco and give XMG an opportunity to get rounds on the board. Fnatic are the ones who are winning those rounds, basically, the important money rounds. And right now, XMG, again, they're just getting mowed down. Fnatic with a very clean anti-eco so far.
Yeah, actually, Fnatic are weirdly doing this mainly with pistols, or at least JW killed two people already with the CSET 75 instead of the AWP, just to point out maybe how good that pistol can be in the right hands. Kevin coming up from short here. It's actually going to be a 2-on-3, and because Pronax is kind of low, maybe they could make it a 2-on-2.
Well, if they can find Pronax, I mean, only 18 points of health. PNX is looking mid. He's going to spot a man out. That's Krim's kind of dancing, trying to keep an eye on B site, keeping an eye on mid. Kev is going to come back to support, however. If PNX can find this shot with the AK, that would be huge. But he's been dropped down to 17 HP, and he has no Kevlar, so he isn't too tough right now.
Flusher in the background. They're both solo right now on the myXMG top squad, and they should both be going down any second. Just a bit of a shooting gallery going on, and Fnatic will pick up the round. That's 11-3, and it's really, I mean, the most we can say so far about this first half is that there's been a few openings where myXMG had a chance to chain some rounds together, and Fnatic have simply denied those rounds to them, so they're left with three. You know, three scattered rounds, basically.
Yeah, that's pretty much what happened. Every time myXMG has had the opportunity to put Fnatic on an eco, and stuff like this happens. JW picks off Kevin through the smoke.
Yeah, looking really, really great, Fnatic, and I think that's just what we're expecting, but myXMG, they want to see if they can at least make it 11-4 here, and they have a really good shot of doing it. 3-on-4, and retaking the B-bomb site with a man down is just it's not fun at all, so we'll see if they can manage it, Fnatic, anyway. But right now, the Danish team should be able to put up a good defense.
Well, right now, it's a bit of a mix, right? Flusher's kind of waiting at window, seeing if he can pick somebody off, but this man advantage makes a world of difference right now for myXMG, and Fnatic aren't going to back off, not in the 15th round, but it's going to be a tough retake here for Fnatic. They're just going to run right into the blender. Hunden and PNX already picking up two, and the last man, Pronax, trying to make his way through window, just spaces down four rifles, and that does not go his way. So, last round of this first half, XMG pick it up, but it's still an 11-4 finish we're looking at here.
Yeah, and we said it at the start. We kind of expected Fnatic to get out of this game with a 2-0 victory, but I think Fnatic played really well. I don't think actually myXMG are doing things that awfully.
No,
and
I
agree. it's just a matter of small details, as you've pointed out. The fact that they never were able to break Fnatic. If they're able to break Fnatic's economy, then that should easily be two rounds in a row, and they've had three opportunities to do so. So, you know, they could potentially be at seven rounds, which is, I guess, an okay result to go off of, given how they lost the their first anti-eco after picking up the pistol.
And, I mean, it also came down partly, I think, to some smart decisions from Fnatic. I especially enjoyed that round. I think it was in the fourth or fifth round where they managed to rush the middle right when myXMG had managed to buy. I think that kind of play, I mean, it's a bit risky for Fnatic because if they lose it like they did later in the game, if they lose that round that early on, then they could be ecoing instead, and actually that would give myXMG a pretty big opening. But as it turned out, they managed to sort of rob myXMG of some sort of beginning momentum. And that's really hard to deal with. I mean, and this is the kind of map that Dust 2 is. We've seen this from a lot of teams as well. That sometimes, even on the CT side, you get off to a good start. This is the result. We'll have to see if myXMG can bring it back here, as they are in a pretty big deficit on the first map only. We do have a best of three on our hands, so they're going to have more chances to try and bring it back here. But pistol round obviously going to be important right now. And Fnatic there on the terrorist side. It's a great shot to begin with. Look at Pronax and T-Spawn already down to 23.
Yeah, how does this shape up, though? Because the smoke is down blocking off mid-doors right now, so myXMG, Fnatic, both kind of limited our information. This works more for Fnatic, seeing as how they're going to be able to sneak their way around here, but Hunden is holding so close to make up for this smoke. He's trying to listen right now. He's trying to hear who's going to be coming through, and he is not going to get a kill as they come rushing through the doors. He loses his teammate as well, and that's two very quick kills there given by Olafmeister.
Very unfortunate for myXMG, because that was a pretty good setup, but the flashbangs were so good from Fnatic that they just kind of shut down that middle area. And now it's a 2-on-4 with the bomb down, some Molotov on PNX, which is actually not a bad tool for retaking the B-bomb site, because you can definitely use that in the right way. Pronax is going to go down and making it a 2-on-3 out in the middle. If he can pick up this kill, he will. PNX with a running headshot, and now it's a 1-on-2. They're actually doing this. Flusher, he's almost out of bullets here. He's going to have time to reload, though. PNX is in the bomb site, and this Molotov can save him right now. What's Flusher gonna do?
He's got the kit. Flusher has to run through it. Flusher drops down to 25. He's just running and gunning, and he gets the kill blind. Completely blind, Flusher.
Just Flusher things, right? flash and run yourself through a Molotov with just 60 points of health and get the running blind USP shot. That's ridiculous.
He was completely ridiculous. Blind there. How? That was just perfection for him to know exactly where to aim, for him to just manage to pick up that shot like that. Just sick play from Flusha. Hashtag just Flusha things, of course. Again, the man is here. He's shown up on land.
And actually, it's a very sad story overall, because that was such a cool retake from myXMG. I mean, you're 2-on-4 in a pistol round. You're really not supposed to win it, not even close to win it. And they definitely could have then. Flusha, he's not going to let up from last round either. Picks up a triple here. He's dropping 24 kills in just 17 rounds, which is just kind of absurd.
It is. Flesh has been very active in every eco round that myXMG has had. That has to be said. So I think he's picked up quite a few frags from that. But still, obviously, 24 frags, 5 assists, and only 9 deaths. Tells the tale, really. He's been playing really well for Fnatic.
No doubt about it. And Fnatic have just no fear right now. They're willing to take fights. CZ, not P250, doesn't care. But Kev will actually get the punish on JW, who only had a CZ 75, but still gets the headshot with his USP. Pronax with the P250 goes right back to work, though. Picks up 2 kills. And this is going to be Fnatic just kind of closing in on this A site. Not a whole lot that XMG can do right now to stop this, it seems. They are stacked up at mid, but that's not where this the action's going to be. Fnatic, they've taken over long, and they're working their way up.
But what I like about this stack is that it means that PNX can be absolutely sure no one's coming short, and he should be waiting. I'm not sure why he's not waiting, because if he waited there until they tried to put the bomb down, maybe he could pop out and kill the bomb hunter. Now, I think he just missed the timing a little bit here, and he's trying to find it out. He's out of bullets, and he should be going down any second. So, I actually like the idea. I think if they had just waited another 2 or 3 seconds, that would have been an interesting setup.
I think he was afraid of getting caught out and basically just overmanned from that position, because he has nowhere to actually fall back to. And if Fnatic pushes out with 3 or 4 members, then what's he going to do? Because there's no way he's going to actually down all of the Fnatic members in just one go.
You have to believe. No, I know you. I know you're right. I just thought maybe he could kill the bomb planter, and sometimes that causes like some amount of confusion. But you're right. He wouldn't have killed like 2 or 3 people if he had been there. But still, maybe backup could have arrived or something while they were gunning at him. Sometimes it does take a while to kill people when they're hiding in this really annoying spot.
Oh yeah, there's definitely. I mean, you can definitely make an argument as to him staying in that corner. Obviously, that gives time for Tensky and MSL to rotate over, and that could easily fluster Fnatic.
Well, auto sniper on MSL gets taken down, but there's also Hunden with the return. Right now, it's Tensky defending this bomb site, and backup is coming. Somehow, CT spawn is not smoked off here. JW wants to take the find, and he's gonna get it as well. Hunden wanted to throw a grenade, and actually, I think that grenade would have pretty killed JW, so it's not even like it was a horrible idea, but sometimes it can be a big risk pulling out those grenades.
And JW with the sixth sense right there. Somehow knew, or he felt, the presence of PNX pushing up from behind long.
Still brought it back into a 2-on-2 somehow, and the auto sniper and AWP are both alive right now on myXMG's side, but they're not in the right position.
Yeah, they get the right timing here, Fnatic, to make this A play after all. Kev has rotated down into CT spawn. He's looking towards that site, but the angle is not going to help, and Olafmeister will get the plant fairly easily here. Flusha decides to take a peek, though, and that's risky business, especially when you're facing down, well, one scoped rifle now. Tensky has worked his way around long. There's the shot, but Olafmeister will shut down Kevin, and now they have control of Cat, and this is the important thing for Fnatic, because Tensky is coming from long, and this is where they have to be just shutting him down. Olafmeister, second frag for him this round, and that puts Fnatic at 15 rounds now, one round away from securing the first map.
Yeah, a bit of a tough position. I mean, again, it's good work for myXMG that they managed to stabilize some of those situations, because, in fact, as soon as they lost Hunden down in towards the A ramp, they could have lost the B bomb site almost immediately. But they managed to sort of stabilize and bring it back, and that's nice work, but it's not enough right now to beat Fnatic. Not even close.
I really did like the SCAR 20 play, but I also liked how Fnatic slowed down the pace, and instead of trying to YOLO down a SCAR 20, they really took their time with approaching that B site or just making the call afterwards. to go to A. Right now, it's just a firefight at B. Pretty much, Fnatic are going to brute force their way out and nade Kevin down. Two nades to the face, and he's gone. And now it's only one man left alive, Hunden, trying to put some shots through.
Look at JW. Oh, PNX is actually going to spot him out. He realized there's a weird smoke in this spot, and JW, he tried to play the sickest mind game, but it doesn't work out. I think he's going to be sad at that. He wanted to have some fun there.
Speaking of mind games, look at Ulfmeister outside of B. He kind of just let Hunden pass.
Yeah, hiding in the smoke, and he's going to walk out just at the right time, pick up the headshot, and that'll be 16-4 in favor of Fnatic on the first map in this best of three. Next map coming up, guys, is going to be Mirage, but overall, I don't think there's not really much we can say else here. Fnatic, they're one hell of a strong team. They came inches away from winning Gamescom, the last major, and I think...